Welcome to presentation. Hello everybody, a very good morning to you all. I am Mahfooz Akhtar here. I would like to talk about recognizing artist style automatically in painting using convolutional and neural network. Objectives: the aim is to design a deep learning model to recognize artist style in painting and support reliable, quick and accurate identification and recognition. Furthermore, to improve the MiniVisiNet to provide great performance. Figure 1 shows the basic workflow diagram. Now let's move on the next topic. Motivation. In the current decades, artist style recognition is an important and active research area in the field of computer vision. Recent advances in imaging and multimedia technologies have paved the way for automatic analysis of art. However, each individual artist also has a unique signature which is hard to detect with algorithms and objective features. Application of artist style recognition. Recognition of artist style has attracted the attention of many researchers because of its various applications. Few of those applications are academic and commercial fields, assist in organizing large collections of paintings, allows curators, educators, curious painting viewers and art students to automatically tag objects and allow visitors to browse paintings more freely. Robotic applications that require information about different paintings. Challenges: image size. In the case of large images, it is difficult to load and consume more time, difficult to confine the characteristics. Extraction of artist style feature is very difficult. Indeed, although standard classification tasks such as facial recognition can rely on clearly identifiable features such as eyes or nose, classifying artist styles cannot rely on any definitive features. Related work. Painter classification over the novel art painting dataset via the latest deep neural networks. In these papers, authors proposed a convolutional neural network to classify painting images from challenging environments. Authors tested their designed model with the challenging test dataset, which are collected from different art movements. Deep Painter, painter classification using deep convolutional autoencoders. In these papers, they described the problem of painter classification and an autoencoder-based deep CNN model is proposed. The results presented in this paper showed that the proposed model is better than the state of the art. Art painting identification using convolutional neural network. They compared the proposed model with the handcrafted feature, that is sieved method, and shows the output. A deep convolutional neural network for fine art paintings classification. In this work, they presented a study using CNN for fine art painting classification. Firstly, authors developed an end-to-end DCNN model to examine the capability of CNN model. Finally, authors argue that the fine art painting classification is more challenging with respect to the other classification model, such as face or object recognition. Workflow diagram. In this thesis work, first we have preprocessed the dataset. Then we have normalized the dataset and resized all the data. Then we have divided into the labeled data two parts, training part and testing part. 80% of images of the dataset are used to train the model and 20% of the dataset are used for test the model. Then we have extracted the feature of the images by applying proposed model in convolutional neural network and predicted in dense layer. Figure 4 shows the overall workflow diagram of our I have already discussed this slide. This slide also have been discussed in workflow diagram. Proposed framework. In our proposed model, 32 filters consist in the first convolutional layer and filter size is 10 to 3 and each has 3 channels. Same padding is used by us, that is the input pictures are zero padded in such a way that the filters convolve over each pixel of input picture. In the convolutional layer, we used an activation function, that is ReLU. To improve model performance and stability, the best normalization is used. The size of max pooling is 2 into 2 that moves by a stride of 2 on the feature maps. It performs max pooling operation. For dropping on the neurons, we have used a dropout layer to prevent the model from overfitting to the training data. For the first convolutional layer, dropout value has been set to 0.20. 64 filters of size 3 into 3 and each contain 3 channels. The second convolutional layer is made. Here the same padding is also used. To the feature maps, the ReLU activation function is also applied. In the second layer, to improve the model performance again, the batch normalization is used. The size of max pooling filter is 2 into 2 that moves by a stride of 2 and on the feature maps. It executes max pooling operation. For second convolutional layer, the value of dropout is 0.25. After setting the dropout value of second convolutional layer, a flattened layer has been used. The final pool layer's result is flattened into a vectorized type and succeeded by a fully connected layer which has 512 neurons. For using the final features which are extracted from the preceding pooling layers and convolutional layers to classify the picture into the several classes in the output layer, fully connected layers are used. We have applied batch normalization again. Then we used the dropout value 0.5. For activation function, we used ReLU again. Finally, the output layer consists of 6 nodes representing 6 classes. Then we used softmax activation function for output. I have already discussed this slide in the proposed framework. Datasets. We used WikiPaintings dataset in our experiment. The images were arranged in 29 different folders and we took 6 folders from them. Figure 7 shows sample images of WikiPaintings dataset. Real-time images with respect to WikiPaintings dataset. Figure 8 shows some examples of images of experimental settings. Programming language, we have used Python programming language libraries which are Keras and TensorFlow. Jupyter Notebook and Google Collaboratory are used as IDE. We used ADAM optimization. 10 epochs are used for training. For optimization, an empirical learning rate is used, that is 0.10. Experimental analysis. Figure 9 shows the accuracy and loss curve of WikiPaintings datasets. Training and validation loss curve, training and validation accuracy curve. Figure 10 shows the confusion matrix of the predicted results of MiniVGDNet without normalization confusion matrix and normalized confusion matrix. Table 1 shows prediction score for each level of WikiPaintings datasets, which are the performance analysis of MiniVGDNet using WikiPaintings data. Figure 11A shows training and validation loss curve of WikiPaintings dataset and 11B shows training and validation accuracy curve of WikiPaintings dataset. Figure 12A shows without normalization confusion matrix of predicted results of proposed network and figure 12B shows normalized confusion matrix of the predicted results of proposed network. Performance analysis of proposed model using WikiPaintings dataset. Table 2 shows prediction score for each level of WikiPaintings data. Experimental result on WikiPaintings dataset for MiniVGDNet is presented here for random test images. Figure 13 shows art style recognition with confidence scores and B recognition confidence scores in the bar chart. These are other examples of experimental results of Wikipaintings dataset for MiniVGGNet. This slide also shows the other examples of experimental another example of experimental result of Wikipaintings dataset. These are other examples of experimental result. Now let's move on the next topic. Misclassified by MiniVGGNet and correctly classified by proposed model. Some images are misclassified by MiniVGGNet and those are correctly classified by proposed model. Figure 19 shows misclassification by MiniVGGNet and figure 19b shows correctly classified by proposed model. This slide shows another example of misclassification and correctly classification by proposed model. This slide is another example of misclassification. Now let's move on the next slide. We have used three types of learning rate schedules and got better result when we use polynomial learning rate schedule. Table 3 shows accuracy using different learning rate schedule. Table 4 shows the performance comparison of the MiniVGGNet and proposed network with other recent related work. Discussion. The proposed model gives better results for small datasets. Also, gives extremely well confidence scores. It does not misclassify any expression level. The overall accuracy of the proposed model is 60.37 for the Wikipaintings dataset. Conclusion. In this work, a CNN architecture is proposed. The proposed CNN automatically detects several characteristics of individual paintings to support quick, accurate, and reliable identification and recognition. Future work. In future, we will work on large dataset and will try to improve the performance of our model for other largest dataset and improve accuracy. These are the references of our work. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed it.